This tree is a magnolia tree, and I love this tree because, you know, it's as old as Kathalia is. And it has been a silent witness to so many courses that have happened at our center here. And I wish sometimes I could be like this. So I always switch between silence and storytelling. Sometimes I think I'm like this tree, and sometimes I'm blah, 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 telling stories. And it was a lot of trees around me one morning, I remember. I always loved looking at trees, even sipping my coffee, watching a tree opposite my house. And it was one of those days in 1998, I remember, when I got up. And I was teaching at this beautiful campus in Valley School, where we were teaching subjects after subjects. And I think teachers bring an old mind wherever they are. It doesn't matter whether it's an open ambience or, you know, it's a closed ambience. Our minds don't change. So here I was like questioning myself. I said, why are teachers still continuing to teach the same way? And why are children bored, whether it's an open ambience or a closed ambience? Because I had taught in different schools earlier too. And here, this morning I said, I thought of what Krishnamurti had said, saying that if you have to change, it has to be today or now. You have to see the urgency of change. So I said, why should I wait for a principal, director, someone to do something? Why don't I effect a change in the way I'm teaching children, you know, and facilitating a lesson, especially being a history teacher? And that's when I thought, I always grew up with stories, and how happy I was when my father used to tell me stories in the night, you know, about Julius Caesar and Napoleon. That made it so interesting for me. And my mother, she always told stories in Tamil and always made me understand concepts through Tamil stories. And also, you know, language development happens when somebody orally transmits. So here I was saying, I spend most of my time orally transmitting something to children. Children are looking at me. Why don't I tell a story from the history lesson? And that's when I told them, I remember the story of Akbar and Birbal, and how Birbal always questioned Akbar. And Akbar always had to, you know, loved Birbal because of his intellect. And it always, so it has to be problem solving. It has to leave, it has to linger in children's minds. You don't just start and stop a lesson. So that's how I think I wanted to make it interesting. And that morning I thought, why aren't we even having storytelling as a subject? And so Kathalia actually began that way, where I started teaching stories through, I started teaching history through stories, and English language also through stories. And then three of us decided in the school that we must start something from the storytelling organization. And it just happened one morning. I think I kept all my windows and doors open. Like the air that comes in from all the doors and windows, stories just stormed us. Okay. And we said, let's call it what? Katha Tha, Katha Mandir, and all names occurred. And I remember we even decided the name within 2 hours. And we said Kathalaya, because I loved Himalayas. And so I think, like a house or a temple of snow, we said we make it a temple of stories. So in 1998, this great journey started, and we just planted the seed of this tree too. And just as it's grown and it's branched out, today Kathalia has branched out. And we've reached almost, not only children. See, the other problem is that people always thought, though we started with children, we've now moved on like tributaries, like how a lake or, a river, you know, it has different tributaries, like the five rivers, Indus, Satluj, you know, Bias and things like that. So the five tributaries that we branched out to also was, one was Kreni, and one was the Academy of Storytelling, and the third was revival of storytelling forms, to see that other storytellers, the ancient folklorists, also get a chance to revive their traditions. And last but not the least, I think, is also storytelling performances, events and festivals. And one which has lingered on, or which we have probably given more weightage to has been training in itself. And I think we moved on from just an international academy for as an institute for storytelling with a beginner's course and a diploma course, certificate courses. There was a lot of experimenting and we fell a lot of times before we actually came up with a course. Now we are into corporate storytelling, so everyone comes with a serious thing. Oh, what are you going to do about change management, design thinking? But I feel all these are just words. Because what we concentrate is more of the emotional quotient of the individual. Because if the emotional quotient of an individual is not aligned with the mind, body, soul, and if the passion is not there, mainly the interest, then any job falls apart. So you can call it anything, but at the soul of it, I think it's stories at your heart. If I feel that this story, if I believe that a story can change the way that a person is thinking, I'm affecting a thought process. So when I want to do it, so how does it matter whether you're doing it for a corporate or you're doing it in a certificate course for a teacher, for a grandparent? If that person is convinced and believes, yes, this is a great tool that I can start communicating, that I can start using and changing people's lives. And that's what our vision was, to make a positive social change in the society. So mainly shifting thought processes of individuals from a hurried, stressed life to having the learning outcomes, what they call as return of investment. You will get much more, but you'll have to apply it from your soul. So we are, even whether it's a corporate course or the diploma course or the beginner's course or even a short workshop, that we give a lot of weightage to the emotional quotient and what a person feels, where he can find a story, what kind of story can he tell, which automatically boils down to how you communicate. So looking into the eye with integrity, with confidence, is what we are always aiming at. Because today that's lacking with people. Because everyone is. And so they're becoming very numb to it. They can't put five sentences together. They can't feel. And they're doing everything in a very rhetoric manner. So can I change that? Can I bring that passion? Can I bring that interest? Is what we are striving. Whether we call it a corporate course, or a certificate course, or a diploma course. Of course, there are differences in the way we have designed the courses, because the beginners is just a beginners in storytelling, the diploma or the certificate is more professional, it is more skill-based. With the corporate, we also address customer relations, communication, leadership skills, probably a little bit of diversity. So all this is what we try to address through the corporate courses. So I'm sure storytelling will continue. There is a need. It has picked up very well. It has stayed. It's as old as the streets, as old as the seas. So storytelling's future, I have no doubt, will continue. So it's not only about what Kathalia is doing now, but what it leaves behind as a trail. Several organizations that have started. Kathalia itself has trained so many people that people are now being trained to carry the legacy forward. And I'm sure that over the years, in the future, it will continue to not only one tree, but we've planted many seeds that will grow into many trees.